Today we're going to have a look at this CamSwan, maybe, if I'm pronouncing it right, CamSwan action camera, and this is the model F60, and if you're interested in purchasing this, link to buy will be down below in the description. So this is a Wi-Fi 1080p action camera, so basically a very, very good, well-priced GoPro alternative, and we might even compare it to my Xiaomi Yi Action Pro as well in another video. So what's so good about this? It's super waterproof apparently. It's got excellent design, international waterproof standards as well. So let me just get a close up so you guys can look. Peer-to-peer Wi-Fi connect computer through Android iOS smartphone. We've got 170° super wide angle lens, reveals extreme broad scenery. Loop recording using new smart overlapping technology. Okay. We have 1080p HD video recording, HD resolution, high frame rate. The coding is at H.2.64, so the video's compression mode authorized by ITU, industrial full 6 glass lens. Time-lapse photography can be considered as the opposite of high-speed photography or slow motion. So that's pretty cool. It comes in this nice big box as well. Maybe a bit too big for what you really need, but at least it comes in a nice box. Let's go ahead and let's open it up. Let's see what we have in here. So we've got the actual camera here and we've got the accessories. So let's go ahead and have a look at the accessories first and then we'll have a look at the camera last. So open this box up and let's see what we got. So we have, first things first, a clip. There's no point really taking this out and showing this. It's just some clips so you can attach it. We got the clamping thing as well, another one of the accessory clips, so you can attach the camera to it and maybe attach it to a selfie stick or a tripod. Again, another one of those clips. That's really nice that it comes with all this. We've got the two big mount clips as well, so you can loosen this up, attach it to like a pole or something, squeeze it in, you can attach the camera to a pole. So really, really useful stuff really, but I've pretty much got a lot of these things. Again, another clip with a tripod thread on there this time, so you can attach it to a tripod. So that's a really nice one as well. And another one of those adjustable clips converted to the two end ones. And slightly twisted clip. And another one with the tripod thread and the actual tripod thread itself. That's pretty awesome. And last but not least, a nice big clamp clip which you can sort of clip the actual camera inside of and then again attach it to a tripod thread. So that's really, really nice as well. So that's the accessories it comes with. You can throw that to one side. Let's have a look at the actual camera now. And then we've got another one that says accessories as well, but let's have a look at the camera now. So open this box up. Of course the camera does come well padded with sponge. And here we have the actual camera itself. It does come in its waterproof case. We'll pop that to one side, we'll have a closer look later. We can move the box out of the way now. And we've got one more over here, which I assume is just instruction manuals and warranty books. That's what we got here. We got some sticky pads and a cable, sort of mini metal cable. I'm not too sure what that would be used for. Maybe to clamp it to things. We've got some cable ties as well, again, used to clamp it to your trees or something like that. Whatever, you're gonna use it for sports as an action camera. We've got a nice microfiber cleaning cloth to clean the lens. Very, very nice that it comes with this. We've got the micro USB to USB charging cable. It is a pretty basic cable, you know, for most devices used. Not gonna be a very long cable, but it's nice that it came included. And then we've got some straps as well, so you can strap it to various places or body parts, you know, for the sort of angles that you want, camera angles. Again, so it is an action camera. Obviously, if you're going to use it for like skateboarding or skiing, you'd use this camera for those sort of shots. We then have the user manual, and it is in English and German, and seems to be Spanish and French as well. So yeah, and Chinese as well. So we've got the action camera, user manual over here. We also got a spare back cover, what it seems to be like. So that's very, very good that you actually came with this. I mean, for these sort of products, if you do break the back cover or anything like that, they will be quite hard to find replacements. So it's super, super cool that they gave a spare one. And that's really good, because they will be hard to find, this sort of thing. So do keep these safe. We also got a spare battery as well, so that's another great, great positive thing about this. I mean, again, always great to have a spare battery, and these sort of cameras, I mean, it's not a big brand, and it will be hard to find spare and accessories to it. So the fact that it came with a spare battery as well, very, very good. The battery is 1050 mAh, so that's quite a big battery for a small camera like this as well. And then we also came with another one of those clippy tag things as well, another one of those accessories we can throw that to that side. And I'm just going to go ahead and clean this up, and we'll have a closer look at the camera. I have to say, it does look very, very similar to a GoPro in design as well. So this is the camera, this is the casing it comes in. The buttons are all quite pressable, really, really good. We've also got the top one over here, pressable. It has powered on, so we'll open it up and turn that off. It comes with a release clip over here to open it up, so you can't just open it up. It does clip quite well, so in order to release it, you need to do, like, it is quite tricky to open up the release, and I did realize that as well. So it's something like this. See, it is really, really tricky, so I'm just going to go ahead and do it behind the camera, because it's hard to do it in front of the camera as well. From the tag over here, and just get your nail underneath here and lift it up. So it is quite a bit of a crazy clamp over there they've done, but it is what it is. You can peel off these protectors we have on here and get rid of that. Do have quite a few protectors here and there. And let's pull out the camera from here now, if we can manage to grab it out. It is a very nice tight snug fit as well. That's the waterproof case it comes with. Really, really good. We will have a test with the waterproof case as well. And go ahead and peel off another one of the protectors that was on the lenses. Just stick it somewhere. And this is the camera as well. So we've got this matte black finish all around the camera. We've got 330 Wi-Fi 1080p, so the 30 must stand for 30 FPS. We've got the micro USB port, mini HDMI port, and the micro SD card slot. We also got the what seems to be where the battery would be located. Not too sure how you would take it out, if it's a pulling technique or just a button press. We'll have a closer look at that in just a sec though. I'll figure it out. I'm going to need to use the camera, of course, for a few days or so, see how it is. But it does look a nice snug camera, and it also does come with a screen as well, which is good. So it is seems to be trying to connect. We've got the up and down button over here, and also the Wi-Fi button, and we also seem to have some sort of microphone or speaker located on the side here. You can see over there. But I'm going to go ahead and use this, connect it up to my phone, and we'll see how it runs. Get your phone to the camera. So just open up the user manual, and you can see there's two QR codes here, one for iOS, one for Android. Go ahead and open up a QR scanner on your phone. If you don't have one, you can go ahead and download it from the Google App Store or any other apps that you're using. And you just want to scan the QR code, and simple as that. It will take you to an application called Final Cam, or you can go ahead and search it manually yourself, Final Cam, and then you just want to go ahead and install this. Follow the instructions to connect the connect your phone to the camera, and that's pretty much one of the basic steps there. Was the footage from the Hamswan and a Xiaomi Yi action camera. This is the Xiaomi Yi action camera, and I have to say obviously the Xiaomi Yi is slightly better by quality because it is 2K resolution. This is 1080p, and the Xiaomi sound quality was also better, and this even underwater I felt was a little bit better as well. But the Hamswan did perform very well for the price you're paying, and you get a lot more with the Hamswan as well. You get a lot more accessories, you get all these deals and everything. It's really, really good camera for the price as well, and it definitely did be waterproof because no water got in there at all, not a single drop was inside the case. So it's definitely waterproof and it really did get the job done. I really do like the camera, the quality is nice, the sound quality is decent, and other than that really there was nothing really much wrong with this camera. I did feel like it was making a bit of a noise when you're filming, but I'm sure you're not really going to be using the sound from the camera anyway, because I know I would only use it as an action camera, not really use the sound on there. But it's a very, very good camera, and for the price you're paying, you're getting what you paid for, and it is a good price and a good product as well. Another issue I did not like about this camera was connecting it to my phone. I did show you just before how to do that, and I did that, I followed the application. But the problem is sometimes the Wi-Fi on here is a bit dodgy, and it does sometimes disconnect every now and then. You get a few disconnections here and there, or it doesn't want to connect, and that can be really, really irritating. So I'd sort of just stick with the screen on the back. You don't really need the phone one unless you want to play around with the settings. You're going to need to connect with your phone, because the only way you can adjust the settings on this camera is for connecting it with your phone. Otherwise it's pretty much you're not able to change the settings on here. I wasn't able to take pictures because I couldn't connect to my phone, and I'm using an Android phone, and I couldn't connect to it, and I couldn't take any pictures, and it's very, very irritating. But let's try connecting to it now anyway. So what you've got to do is power it on. Just hold up the top button over here with the Wi-Fi symbol, just hold that up. You can also zoom in and zoom out with the camera as well, actually. If you hold the top button, sorry, then it does zoom in, and if you hold the down button it does zoom out. But if you just press it up once, then it will turn on the Wi-Fi, and then we can go ahead and connect with my phone. There you go, we can go jump on my phone, connect to the Wi-Fi. Yeah, open up the Final Cam app, and I'm going to try and add the camera. Two different things. The default password is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Go ahead and press add, and it connects to the camera. It says it's connected, and then there you go. So sometimes it works, sometimes no, it's a wee bit dodgy. But you can see over here that you've got the camera screen just being followed, and it's a bit laggy. You can see there I have actually moved the camera and it's not really picked it up. So that's the only issue here. It is quite laggy, the app, and that's just really the camera and the UI of the app really. It's just really laggy. So you can see over here, I've moved it up and it's just frozen. So it's quite laggy, but if you want to play around with the settings, you can do that here. Take pictures, play around the volume, play around the lighting. That can all be done from the phone. You cannot do that from the camera. So the phone app is decent, and it also tells you the percentage. The battery percentage is on 24% right now. So the phone app is really decent. You can get a lot done from the phone app as well, so that's really, really nice. It is a good feature, but I really did hope that maybe they would have done settings like that on the actual camera as well, just in case you cannot connect to your phone. But they mainly relied for you to connect to your phone, and that can be quite annoying. But other than that, really, I do like the camera. The build quality is absolutely great. The battery is actually located over here, simply just a slider, and it pops open, so that's really, really nice. got the battery there, and it also did come with two batteries, so that's really good. Battery life on here should last you a good 2 or 3 hours full on usage, should do, and so that's really, really good. Charging it should take about an hour or two as well, and that's pretty much it from this camera. And it's got a nice grip to it, it's got a nice look, and the sound quality does get muffled if you use it in the case. So if you don't need the case, don't use it, use it outside the case. And other than that, that's really it from this Samsung camera. So I think overall score I give it has to be 7 out of 10. I mean, it is decent. It's not going to perform like a GoPro or the Xiaomi Yi cameras, but it's definitely a good bang for your buck, really, if that's the saying. It's really, really good for your money. So link to buy this will be down in the description. Overall score 7 out of 10, and as always, thanks for watching this review.